It's trash day. I'm putting you out. It's trash day. Putting you out. It's trash day. Putting you out of my mind. It's trash day. I'm putting you out. It's trash day. I'm putting you out. Trash day. I'm putting you out of my mind. Now I'm gonna clean up. Now I'm gonna clean up. Now I'm gonna clean up the house. Taking all your garbage. Taking all your garbage. Taking all your garbage.
On July 4th, 1776, our forefathers came together and they celebrated our independence. So every July 4th, we celebrate our independence. But today, today is July 3rd, and today is Can Crusher Day! Mark's cracking beers!
Yeah, happy
I'm not cracking beers
4th
today.
Of July podcast day before.
Happy Independence Day tomorrow, but this is podcast day.
Right, and this is Shock Top Ruby Fresh Grapefruit. Paul's got a disgusted look on his face, but this has been so refreshing. I've drank about 12 of these in the last couple days. They're phenomenal.
It sounds good, but I just cannot. I don't even want a beer right now.
It's too hot for you yet.
I'm warm. I'm grumpy. And
grumpy
tired.
Paul slowly coming back. God damn, I'm glad the day got over with quick.
As soon as the heat comes in, I'm out.
Done. So, we'll jump right into this, and we'll get into the questions. The Stand By Your Man tournament final, tomorrow, 9 a.m.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Liz needs to go right there.
Oh, Ms. Elizabeth won, finally. Which, by the way, Mark was upset about, because it was Brandy versus Miss Elizabeth.
You were, too. You said you were voting for Brandy as well.
I was. And everybody's like, well, I guess we're just going to go old school with everything, blah, blah, blah. No more new school, blah, blah, blah.
No, I did not type that up. The English professors,
you
like,
didn't
stop
type
being
that.
Marks.
You didn't type that up. You said it on the back of the garbage truck.
I did say it on the back of the garbage truck, but the English professor put it out there saying, you know, G. Willigers, come on, let's get your shit together, stop being Marks, and realize the future is now, the future is here. The future was Fyter Fest last Saturday.
Absolutely. But in the Stand By Your Man tomorrow... Stand By Your Man Can Crush the Tournament. Tomorrow, the final is Miss Elizabeth versus the ninth wonder of the world, China.
Yeah.
This could go either way.
It really could because they've both been dominating. They
yeah.
really have been dominating. I thought maybe Steph was going to sneak in there over China, but no. Ha-ah!
We're all tired of the McMahons, but more to that come on that in a minute.
More on that in the pontification.
Pontification.
He actually doesn't say anything about the McMahons this week. He hates them overall. So, not really a question before we get into everything that went on over the weekend and Raw, SmackDown, da-da-da-da-da. Stop mentioning the wild card rule, right?
It's the wild card is over. There's not a brand split anymore.
Because
you have Raw and SmackDown.
You're only... Let's just rehash the wild card. Four people from a... brand can go this way or the other. Those four people were on Raw in the first 5 minutes.
Yeah.
That and then Elias comes out, so there was five, and then I stopped counting. So just stop mentioning it. We're going to not forget about it because it was stupid, but we'll at least let it go. Just stop saying wild card. Just say, we are WWE. This show is Raw. This show is SmackDown.
Yeah. There's not a brand split. There's not separate superstars on either one. And this is better for business, I think.
Ah, is it best for business?
This is what's best for business.
Okay, we won't get into Raw and SmackDown yet. We'll wait for that. You did watch some of, in the OVW report, I'm also going to throw in ROH card that was Saturday night, which was awesome. We'll talk about everything with Paul. It's just going to be a mass chaos today. You did watch some of AEW's.
Yeah, I watched highlights from a YouTube channel. It looked great. Like, I haven't had time to sit down and actually watch it yet. And I'm going to, because it's free on Bleacher Report.
Yeah.
So you'd be dumb not to.
You'd be dumb not to. It was more of... It was a pay-per-view, yes, but it wasn't overabundance of boom bangs and the glitz and glamour. It was kind of what I think their show is going to be.
You got, yeah.
It was 2 hours of wrestling, 2.5 hours of wrestling, not counting the buy-in show. I'm saying from main card to end.
You had guys that aren't really your superstars, to say the least.
I don't...
Your mid-card guys, some of them...
You tell me who isn't a superstar on this roster in my book.
Well,
MJF is the whole effing show.
I get that, but you're going to have a mid-card. There's not... Everybody can't go for the championship all the time.
No, I understand that. Barry Horowitz said it correctly when we interviewed him. He's like, somebody's got to be that... He didn't say loser, but somebody's got to be that loser week after week. MJF just talks well. He's going to be around. Darby Allin, he could probably end up being a mid-carder, but there's so many guys that just excelled that people don't know about. You know, right. If you're not watching indies, you're missing out on more than you know.
And you don't get, and you'll get to see, if you watch the indies, you get to see some of your up-and-coming stars before they're up-and-coming stars.
Yeah, like Leva Bates, I watched... couple years ago, it was in Wrestle Circus. I love, she's a cosplay person. You didn't see her a lot, but then you kind of got around. She's playing this stupid librarian thing right now. I want her to go back to where she comes out as Leva Taker, or she came out as Leva Rider. She makes fun of other pro wrestlers with my quotes. It's just, that's her shtick, and that should be her shtick. Get her out of this library role.
Yeah, this library thing is not...
No, the only librarian we know is... Mrs. English Professor.
Yeah.
And she's got shit on lockdown.
All the time.
The one match I really couldn't care about was on the buy-in. Michael Nakazawa against the CEO of CEO Gaming. I really didn't even know this was going to happen. Alex Jabroni.
Oh.
It was too sticky. It was just too sticky. It ended up being a hardcore match just to...
get everything going.
Yeah. Christopher Daniels against Shima. Shima's somebody I didn't know about. He's awesome. He's going to be somebody to keep your eye on. One of my matches of the night, though, and now I'm going to get to probably where Paul started seeing, was Rio, Nyla Rose, and Yuka. Nyla beat the shit out of these girls.
Oh, just whooped the hell out of them.
But they just kept coming, and it just kept coming. It told, again, we always say this, it told a great story.
I love the double teams to chop the giant down. And then it was a single... like, it was... as soon as they got the big girl down, they went
they
to work
on
each other.
They put on a hell of a show.
Yeah, they went to work on each other.
The giant comes back. They go back. They forget that they're fighting each other. They go back after. And it sold everything.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend, my friend.
Listen to the Edgar Allan Poe over here. Guys, make sure you go and watch it. Hangman Page against MJF against Jungle Boy and Jimmy Havoc. Jimmy Havoc, I'm over with. I really am. Jungle Boy's got a future. I like that he comes in on Tyrannosaurus Rex or what the hell, Luchasaurus.
Luchasaurus.
Yeah. I like that he came on his shoulders. I just can't get over MJF. Like, I need a Dynasty shirt. I need an MJF shirt. I need to pal around with him. The
maybe,
interview that I posted.
Maybe you should get some rubber gloves, bud.
Why?
Just.
Oh. The interview that I posted, he's very language not oriented.
Yeah.
Maybe he doesn't even like him either. But it sold. Tell me that wasn't a great interview.
Well, it was the best interview I've heard.
Just mocking people.
Yeah.
I love that. I'm already all in, pun included, on AEW from the two shows that really have... It's just different. It's wrestling, and there's no 45 minutes of bullshit.
No. There's a little bit of promo, but it's not a lot of promo.
Right. The Darby Allin-Cody match, guys, 20-minute draw, 45, whatever. It seemed like it was only 10 minutes.
Yeah.
But
it was fast.
Cody beating his ass. Darby just not giving up. Beating his ass.
The only move that I had a problem with in this whole match was when he went straight as a board onto the hardest part of the ring. Like, what was he trying to do there?
It's just showing that he's...
It was a bad suicidal.
He'll do anything.
Bump. Yeah, you know what I mean, like he could have sold an elbow drop or something, but he didn't.
It reminded me of PCO just did kind of the same type of bump and hit it when I was down at the Crockett Cup. Everybody's doing something big now on the hardest part of the ring.
Well, it's the hardest part of the ring.
And it's going to hurt just as much.
If not more.
After the Cody match, the Perfect 10, Sean Spears. I don't know if we can call him the Perfect 10 anymore, but Sean Spears comes out. And let's talk about this chair shot real quick.
So I didn't see the actual chair shot. For some reason, that wasn't on the highlights. But I did see Cody just laying there in a pool of blood. I do think that it's a work, personally, because Cody is that kind of guy.
Cody is that kind of guy. And when was the last time we've seen a chair shot to the head? Like, WWE, they're banned.
It's always the back.
Yeah, they're banned. But Cody really didn't even, you know, chair shot to the head, your arms are up at some point. His arms did not go up. They were down. Look at the pictures. It was a work, yes, that he was going to get hit. I think it was too quick that Cody didn't get it on right. You know, the block up. The gouge was a gouge.
Oh, yeah. He bled like a pig.
He got hit by the back, and it kind of dug in. I know it's rounded, but it's still...
No, there's some sharp edges on him.
Yeah.
And Miggs is upset about it, too.
Everybody's a ball of fire today. Really... the Luchas, Laredo Kid against the Young Bucks and Omega. My favorite thing was the whole Mortal Kombat.
Yes.
Stuff that they did. What am I trying to say? Homage, maybe? That was cool. The match itself, I think they're good. They're great. I just continue saying how good they are, but I'm tired of them seeing them against the Lucha Brothers. It's a spot fest. Omega could have done so much more against somebody else. If I'm gonna rip it apart because we're analysts now.
Analyzing things.
I think it could have been another added match with Omega and somebody.
Yes.
They don't need to have this feud. It's gonna happen one more time. Well, maybe not one more time because the next show in July is the Rhodes Brothers against the Young Bucks.
Yeah. And
I don't know what the hell is gonna happen to that, but. There's so much wrestling, by the way, on July 13th that it makes me sick. Because I'm one place, Soup's one place, that show's going on, you're going to be drinking beer somewhere. Like, we're not going to have enough coverage.
There's not going to be enough people to cover everything. But we will get through it, Mark.
We will.
Relax.
And then finally, which it wasn't the main event because it was an unsanctioned match. Lights out, as they said. Johnny Moxicillin.
Johnny Moxicillin
against Joey Janela, and this match was cringeworthy.
Oh, the tacks on the bottom of the feet, no thank you.
Done. Done right there.
There's barbed wire, there was kendo sticks.
Ladder through barbed wire.
Ladders, tables, chairs.
Oh my. The one match, where is it? Oh no, it was on ROH. I'll talk about that later.
More to come on that in a minute.
So... All in all, your clips from AEW, you're going to be all in watching this.
Oh, yeah. We got to quit doing that.
No.
You got to let that go.
So you're all out.
I'm all out of the jokes. All out of the all in.
No more jokes anymore?
All out of the all in thing, but honestly, AEW is going to be the way to go.
Do you really think after watching Raw now, and we'll get to it
after
here in a minute.
After we watched Fyter Fest compared to Raw... Fyter Fest was a 2-hour show, and it was supposedly a main event or a pay-per-view, but it wasn't a pay-per-view. That was like a regular...
Yeah.
I think that's what their house shows are going to be like.
They're called Dynamite on Wednesday night.
And it was more... There was more action, less bullshit, and it was a better quality of everything.
You know what I think that I see AEW doing? If you want their promos, you're going to go to their All Elite YouTube page. If you want to watch promos... They put on promos for half an hour.
Yeah.
Good. If you want to watch them, and I'm going to watch them here and there.
You're going to see promos. You're just not going to see standing in the ring battering for 25 minutes.
Yeah.
It's going to be a quick promo, and then we're going to get to wrestling.
And we're out.
Yeah.
So.
Like old school wrestling days, and that's what.
605 TBS.
That's what we need more of.
I agree.
Old school promos, even... Skits. I'm okay with skits.
Yeah, I'm all right. It's just the 45-minute
like promo. Mr. Perfect. I can always remember the Mr. Perfect when he throws his own touchdown pass.
Or he threw so many darts, dead nut center of the bullseye, splitting themselves. OVW, we're going to touch on it real quick. Paul's been diving back into it, and I'm happy about this. So you have some stuff to say about OVW before I get the report.
Right.
And you still love cash flow.
I'm not a huge cash flow fan. Not a cash flow fan at all.
You like Justin Smooth.
And no, not a Justin Smooth fan either.
I don't know who you like then.
I'm not good with the names yet. The guy with one leg, he's awesome.
Michael Hayes.
I'm a Michael Hayes fan.
You should be a Randall Floyd fan.
I am a Randall Floyd fan, actually. TV champion 2 weeks in a row. This time he was in the third spot of the gauntlet match, TV title gauntlet match. And then he outlasted three opponents, got out of a sleeper hold that was wrecking everybody.
Adam Revolver sleeper hold
that was wrecking everybody. And he made it through the, I want to call him the Black Ninja, but I don't think that's right.
It's a Hood Ninja.
The Hood Ninja. That's so...
We're getting there.
We're getting there.
He still doesn't remember Justin Plummer's name, but that's okay.
Yeah, Jake Plummer, IWC. It's coming up July 13th, just a heads up. No, but yes, there's a lot of things I love about OVW.
One thing I know you love about OVW is they pack everything into an hour.
Yes, I do love that. And I got a little bit of a crush on the women's champion.
Oh, Meg. So you're going to come up and do the interview with me?
Yeah. I'm gonna call her Megatron the whole time.
That's gonna be one we have to do over Skype then.
Yeah, we're gonna have to do that one over Skype. I'm gonna have to get a haircut and clean my act up.
Oh boy.
Just kidding, Teresa. I love you.
Oh boy, your wife's gonna love that. Yeah, I don't know. You got anything you wanna bring up randomly?
No, not really. I mean, like I said, me and you are gonna start doing OVW together. The OVW report will probably be taking place of Raw and SmackDown because...
Yeah.
We might go over winners and losers of Raw and SmackDown, but other than that, I don't know if there's anything to cover.
I think we're going to continue to do what we did last week. We're just going to group them together and say this, touch on the high points.
Yeah.
Because that's what we're going to do again after OVW and ROH here in a minute.
So my OVW thing, this whole date thing with... Are they a tag team? Are they enemies?
No, it's Shiloh Jones and DL3... And they both don't know that they're dating Thunder Kitty at the same time.
Oh.
And they're called the Entourage. So, yeah, they're both together.
So is this going to break up the Entourage?
I'm thinking.
She's really John Lennon. And who's the girl that broke up the Beatles?
Yoko Ono.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's a Yoko Ono. See, that I knew what I was talking about.
I didn't know where you were going.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
You're breaking up the band.
Yeah, it's time. Shiloh needs to go on himself and do some stuff. He does. Big matches tonight, folks, as Thunder Kitty is actually going after the title from Megan Bain, Megatron.
Megatron.
So much is going on. So much in OVW. I got the good to go from the wife and our buddy Chad Miller that I will be down there for the draft. So
nice.
Paul has to deal with Friday without me at work.
I miss you already.
But that's more to come on that in about a month.
In a month. We got a month.
So.
To mentally prepare yourselves.
All right. Next part is going to be a little long because I'm going to touch on ROH and this week's OVW.
OVW, because it just posted where we're talking.
Yeah, Chad Miller, you got to fix that.
Get your stuff ready.
All right, before I get to the OVW report for this week, what was just posted, which I took a minute to watch after we recorded the podcast to put back into here, I want to talk about ROH. Best in the world pay-per-view this past weekend, and oh my God, nobody was there. There was so many empty seats at this arena for ROH, Best in the World. So, pre-show was Flip Gordon against Roosh. Roosh is somebody you guys have to watch out for. What a great match. Flip Gordon, still one of my favorites in ROH, but Roosh gets the win. Aldis comes out and says, hey, Colt Cabana is not going to be able to wrestle. I want to show you who my replacement is as I take on the Briscoes later on tonight. And it's Eli Drake. Eli Drake has now joined the NWA. Guys, yet another promotion that I think is going to blossom here in the near future. The resurgence of the NWA. So I'm pretty excited about that. On to the main show. There was some good. There was some bad. Just all in all, it was an okay event. I'm not going to go match by match. I just wanted to touch on, you know, that it was okay. Like, I see ROH actually taking a few steps back every once in a while. Like, something's happening to ROH that I don't understand. But we're going to kind of really fast forward to the six-man match. It's the Villain Enterprise against Lifeblood and PJ Black. Enterprise keeps the six-man titles. What happened at the beginning is something I'm really grinds my gears, pisses me off. Villain Enterprises came out with the shoulder pads on. All right, yeah, the Legion of Doom wore them. Great, guys, it's been 30 years. Give it up. Other people have worn face paint. Other people have done this. Animal went off that he's upset that he wasn't asked if they could wear these. What the hell? They're shoulder pads. You don't own the rights of shoulder pads. If you don't like it that somebody else is going to copy something, it's what it is. Wrestling has been copied for a long time. Something has been, and it just happened again. Who cares? But the gist of this, of me covering ROH this time because of the pay-per-view is, I didn't have much to do. I wanted to watch some ROH. I was excited to watch some ROH. Flip Gordon's bad, guys. That just makes me love him even more. He joined Villain Enterprises. If you get the chance to watch this Best in the World, go ahead and watch it. It wasn't one of the best, but it wasn't worst. It was a good show. It really was. You'll also see Jeff Cobb against Matt Taven. I really thought it was Cobb's time, but I guess not. So nonetheless, it's time to switch gears and get to talking about truly one of my passions. I love OVW. I love it. You guys know this. You know I make the trek down to Kentucky every once in a while to talk to them. Constantly texting Chad Miller about randomness now, really. So I like talking about OVW. Last week when I really couldn't do a report because it wasn't put up on time, yeah, I'm going to call somebody out. Chad, you can yell at me. I can step back. Well, sorry. But now that it was put up and I get to come back around and add it to the podcast later, I'm pretty excited about it. And this was a great show. I loved what they did the whole show. So Gilbert and Dr. Ted and Josh are all introducing, you know, the show, welcoming everybody to the show. And Smooth comes out, and he's looking for Dean Hill. Well, Dean Hill's on assignment looking for tag teams to face King's Ransom because they just want better competition. Well, Smooth finds out that he's not there, and he says he's the boss. He's going to run this show, and he's going to run it rampant until he finds the man in the mask. Gilbert's like, dude, that's not the way it works. You're the OVW champion, but you're not running the show. Well, Smooth, you know, he's a Smooth operator. The Trinidad Titan, Justin Smooth. I'm sorry, Justin. I should know this. We've talked several times, and I misspeak every once in a while. But nonetheless, the Trinidad Titan, Justin Smooth, your OVW heavyweight champion, gives Gilbert a raise at least. Nonetheless, we go to break, and Smooth is thinking he's running, I don't know, for president or something. I don't know. We come back. We have a quick match as the Live Wire KTD fights Mr. Marvelous. Mr. Marvelous hits that Russian leg sweep, and it's over. Guys, this is going to eliminate anybody with that leg sweep. Probably one of the best Russian leg sweeps I've seen, and that's why he's so marvelous. Smooth comes back out, and now he's just beating the hell out of the production team. I feel bad for them. You know, they're not wrestlers. He's got Brian pinched up against the wall. He's doing this. He's like, whoa, Smooth. It's a masked man. You'll see him again. Calm your jets. Then we have a match scheduled. It's Chase Destiny against Sam Thompson. And I was excited for this match. I really was. These are two young and up-and-comers in OVW, in the wrestling world. And they can put on a show. And here comes Smooth again. Now I feel like Roman Reigns is coming over and over. No, I actually like this. Smooth eliminates both of them. See you later. Get out of the way. Chase eats a street justice. Sam gets punched in the face. Done. He's still looking for that masked man. I don't know who it is. There's a dime right there. Huh. I don't know. Next up is the TV gauntlet. Guys, I'm going to spoil it right now. Wow. Wow, what a turn of events. It starts with Esposito against Kyle Roberts. And Kyle Roberts kind of new, getting his second match in OVW. I said Esposito again. It's Espinoza. I butcher Espy's name all the time. I think it's on purpose. But he does have a new shirt, and it says Espy Day. It's Rusev's, and it says Happy Espy Day. I love it. Sell those on collar and elbow. I love it. SP gets the win. Next out is Floyd Randall. You heard him. Randall. Yes. He beats him. Randall Floyd's a TV champ, guys. There's nobody to beating him, right? Nobody. Well, Floyd wins. Floyd then goes on and beats Drew Hernandez. Then he beats Jay Bradley. But Bradley, the monster of the midway that he is, the hired gun of OVW, just beats Floyd down. Just beats him down. And then leaves. And then the final competitor is William Lutz. Floyd gets some back. He's fighting a little bit. He's fighting a little bit more. And then all of a sudden, a roll-up with some tights gives William Lutz the TV championship. So we have William Lutz as your new OVW TV champion. Guys, I know this has kind of been spoiled because I posted it earlier on Facebook. If you're putting two and two together, nobody has rooted for Lutz. Nobody. Not us. So I'm not jumping on the bandwagon. This is just surprising that Lutz beat Randall Floyd, the real deal, Randall Floyd. Something has to happen. Floyd needs justice. Plus, Lutz had the tights. Where the hell was Daniel Spencer? Well, let me tell you, Daniel Spencer gets something that he deserves later on. KTD's in the back, and after taking that Russian leg sweep, he's getting a massage. He's getting, you know, a little bit of medical attention from Mrs. Al Snow. And then here comes Smooth again. Tosses poor KTD to the side like yesterday's garbage and demands that Mrs. Snow gives Smooth a massage now. I don't know what's going on. Something has to happen with Smooth. Nonetheless, we're ready for the main event, and this is a match that I've been waiting for. The 98-year-old Thunder Kitty taking on Paul's favorite, Megan Bain. And just as they're ready to lock up, Smooth comes out again and messes this match up, and this is where I've had enough. Justin, I don't care what you do, but Megan Bain is just as important as you, and you are just in everybody's way, and that's just getting to be too much. Finally, the women are going to take it upon themselves, and he pushes them down and punches them. Well, in the ring, Spencer gets punched. Thank God. Daniel Spencer gets punched. He wasn't doing anything correct anyway this week, so you might as well take him out, Smooth. So props on that one. But then jumping into the ring, Dr. Ted gets in. He gets taken out. Brittany comes in to check on him. Mercy comes in to watch over both of them. Mercy gets taken out. Josh Ashcraft comes in, gets taken out. Gilbert almost gets drug into the ring. Then he grabs Brittany again, and he's going to punch her, and Smooth is just going nuts. Finally, the masked man comes out. And just as he's ready to punch poor Brittany Devil Ray, he takes the mask off and reveals that it's Dimes. And then just as Smooth goes after him, Dimes kind of scurries out of the way, and Dustin Jackson, with a spear heard around the world, boom, lays out Justin Smooth, and that's the way the show ends. Dustin Jackson has taken Smooth out the last 3 weeks. This weekend is SNS on July 6th. I cannot wait to reach out to our correspondent in Kentucky to talk about this later on next week to find out what happened before next week's show is rolled out. Is Dustin Jackson in line to be your new OVW champion? I guess we'll have to wait. Guys, OVW is heating up. You can find it on YouTube. You can find it on their OVW network. $4.99 a month, guys. You get all the pay-per-views and everything then. It's $4.99 a month. Make sure you get it. It is worth every cent. OVW, it's where it's at. It's really, really, it's an hour of wrestling and storylines. And coming up is our favorite sponsor, Collar and Elbow.
Wrestling, a love and a passion we all share. I've started a wrestling brand, the wrestling brand. A brand founded on the aspects of wrestling. Two entities working together to create a product that connect emotionally for people everywhere. Collar and Elbow is the brand. Passion and love for wrestling is the drive. I am Al Snow, and this is Collar and Elbow, the wrestling brand.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Randall Floyd, the three-time Ohio Valley Wrestling Television Champion. And you right now are listening to the Can Crushers podcast.
Big thing from Randall Floyd, your OVW TV champ. And we might have a little bit of a surprise coming up, don't we, Mark?
Oh, well, it's not a surprise because you can tell that that has been recorded for Can Crushers, which means this week's Spotlight...
Friday Spotlight is Randall Floyd.
This interview with Randall was so much fun. Just a spoiler, he's a huge Macho Man fan. Well, so
I couldn't tell from the mustache.
Right, and he really wants to punch me in the face.
Good.
You'll have to listen.
I really like that.
You'll have to listen Friday.
This is another reason why he's one of my favorites.
He really wants to punch me in the face. Now I called him out.
When he goes down, when you go down for the draft,
when he's going to beat my ass.
Yes.
Probably won't come back.
Just take pictures.
Well, the wife will be there to take pictures.
Good.
So this is why I'm saying Vince McMahon is scared. To have your two big men, not main eventers,
your two monsters.
Yeah. Destroy the stage. And
destroy
each other. I have more on that because I really am pissed about this whole thing. He threw everything out. You had a shit within the first 5 minutes of Raw. You have people yelling that they're pregnant. You know, you just have a conglomerate of random attitude-esh stuff. Vince is scared.
I don't know if he's scared. I think that he doesn't know where to go or what to do right now. He is in trouble, but he has no way to fix it, and he's trying to figure it out.
Well, making Paul Heyman running Raw and Eric Bischoff running SmackDown is... You're bringing two your... Heyman's been there, but now you're bringing Bischoff back.
For the third time.
And he's the guy that was running WCW when they closed.
Right.
So...
Well, he was running WCW when they were NWO.
As hot as well. Yeah. Right. Yes. I mean, touche.
But you're also seeing factions come back together.
Yeah,
Or being formed, and I'm pumped for the club.
Yeah, I do like this faction of the club.
So just so you know, it was Ricochet versus AJ Styles at the main event of Raw, and Ricochet gets the 1-2-3, and here comes AJ Styles, or here comes Gallows and Anders, and they are just whooping his butt.
I thought maybe I was going to see Finn Balor come out, and there's going to be a bait and switch, I think, with this whole non-wild card. I think there's going to be a bait and switch coming because Finn's not doing anything with that IC title.
I think he's hurt because I haven't even seen him on
Nothing.
SmackDown.
He's not even on main event.
He's really Brock Lesnar-ing now the Intercontinental Championship.
He really is. But I think Ricochet kind of buddies with him, bait and switch, and then you have a four-person faction.
Right.
And Finn belongs in that Balor
and
Club.
And I want to see more than just that. I want to see the club take over. I want to see different guys.
Don't get it to where you're bringing Virgil in.
No, nothing like that. But I'd like to see maybe 10 guys in it.
That's a lot nowadays.
But it's not. They have what's their roster size right now?
Well, a couple weeks ago,
over 60.
Yeah, and 14 have only been on shows.
Right, so now you got stuff to do with the other guys, too. And with the 24/7 championship, having them guys get on TV just to run around and chase somebody, that's not really a wrestling match.
No, you're not using them.
No.
Titus O'Neil is seen every week, running. Great. I hope he's making a lot of money.
Running. Looking like Forrest Gump.
Run. So, let's get back to the beginning of Raw, where they just blew shit up. Now, I'm going to stop and pause. Great segment. I loved it. I did. But now let me rip it apart. You blew everything up, and there's still one camera working. Only one camera, where you can see behind the scenes. Why not have the cameraman shooting that? It makes it more real.
Right.
Why not, when they're getting wheeled out, throw some soot on them? They have just went through a world war with the fire and everything.
And they were carted off in ambulances, and Braun actually needed to be carted off in an ambulance. He actually got hurt doing it.
They said he broke his spleen, and he's going to be out for a while.
Yes. So there's another. Now you just hurt your monster.
But I think this is good. Not that he's hurt. We're not saying that.
No, but he needed. Now
he
gets a
break. I think this is a break. He gets refreshed. Forget about him for 3 or 4 months. So really.
What do they do with Bob now?
I don't care. Send him back to
anywhere.
Send him
after Rollins' title.
Well, yeah.
That's what he's here for. They brought him.
He was supposed to fight Lesnar.
Yeah, and then that never happened.
No. No.
And that's something that I want to see, actually. A Lesnar-Bob match.
Lesnar-Bob or yeah, Lesnar-Rollins?
Lesnar-Bob. I've seen Lesnar-Rollins 6 times now.
Well, you're not going to see Lesnar anytime soon, I don't think.
He's under contract.
Yeah, I know, but I mean,
He's your Brock in the Bank.
Right. And they're going to tease that till forever, and it's going to be SummerSlam.
Probably the day before WrestleMania.
That'll suck. That'll really suck. So, we're going to jump into New Day. New Day is everywhere. They literally are on every show.
Every show.
As much as Roman has.
Saturday night main event.
Anything.
Anything.
I wish they'd bring Saturday night's main events back.
They have it. It's on the network, bud.
No, I know. No, the good ones.
Oh.
Like when it, yeah, the good ones. Like it's War Raiders. The War Raiders need titles. They need something. They really do. I really love them.
They don't have. This brings me back to the Bludgeon Brothers. They don't have much of a backstory or much of a personality. To just slap some titles on them.
They need somebody that can speak for them.
Right. Are you sure? Because maybe they can speak.
Raymond Rao, Eric or whatever one he is. He's from IWC. I know he can speak. I've seen him there. He's been in ROH. He can speak. He's a good speaker. They don't want them to speak here. They're Vikings.
They're Vikings.
They eat turkey legs and sail on ships to get from every event. No?
No. Well, I mean, maybe, but
I don't know how they're going to get from, like, Salt Lake City to Michigan, maybe. But nonetheless.
Yeah, nonetheless.
Nonetheless. More on that later. No. It's time to drink, by the way, folks. It's drinking game time. So this all turns into a 6-man match. Do you see Joe beating Kofi? Do you think Kofi's...
No, I don't see Joe beating Kofi. The War Raiders did work well with Samoa Joe. It was a good tag match. I thought it was very well performed
Paced,
match. Performed match.
Yeah. But now you have New Day also in a mix on... They're on two storylines. Because now they're in a mix over on SmackDown with Daniel and Heavy Machinery and KO and Zig now.
I think the KO and Zig thing is done. I think that's going to be your new feud.
That's a feud I can get behind.
I'm going to like to see this.
They both can
talk. I like
talk.
How KO is a... He's a heel... But he was also putting it to Shane McMahon. So we're on to SmackDown now, and we'll go back to Raw.
We'll bounce.
Yeah.
Because I want to talk about your favorite wrestler.
Let's talk about one right now.
Jose made him.
No way. Jose. No way. Jose. And this is where the 24/7 title gets in the way. Because I not that I want to see Cesaro kill No Way Jose.
What?
But I want to see the wrestling match. I want to see them wrestle. I don't need to see Drake Maverick... win his 24/7 championship.
And he's excited.
And he's now your new champion.
Yeah, he's taking care of his honeymoon.
Yep.
And Renee Michelle is pissed.
She's upset.
Divorce, and when we see, I don't know, maybe Instagram or YouTube this weekend. Wherever they are, Key Largo or wherever, Kokomo.
I'm guessing Jamaica because...
You just went all the way with me. Good, nice.
R-Truth can perform there.
Right. Okay. Nonetheless, that's where he's going to win the title back.
Yes.
And divorce papers next week for Drake Maverick. And he's going to become a raging alcoholic, which is a nice gimmick. I like that.
Yeah. You got us one, Drake.
Yeah.
Just don't pee yourself again.
How about the Street Profits making their way up to Raw first?
Still wearing the NXT titles.
Yeah.
Are you going to see a lot more of the NXT guys making Raw... and SmackDown, home.
I think. I really do. The English professor gives a little shout-out to some other people that have Red Solo Cups, and they were champions, and they live in Toronto, and it's Fraternity Forever.
Is it the fraternity?
I don't know. I'm just saying he gives a shout-out. So, Drew and Shane all over the place.
I'm saying they're not afraid of The Undertaker, and then The Undertaker comes out, and they look pretty afraid.
Yeah, first you get...
And Kevin Owens is going to tell us more about that on SmackDown.
You get the lightning strike.
On the Kevin Owens show.
Lightning strikes, thunder rolls, you know.
All the cool stuff. I'm surprised that even worked with all the stuff being down, because the two built monsters went through the Titantron.
This is what I'm saying! Right after all of this happened. See how... I segued you into it. Right after all this happened, everything was black for a match. Undertaker comes out, everything works again.
Well, he's the Undertaker, he's the Phenom.
Oh, so he's electricity.
Boogie, woogie, woogie.
What?
It's electric. Boogie, woogie, woogie.
Are you sick of 2 out of 3 matches?
I'm sick of a lot of the stuff WWE's doing.
Right.
We're, 10 minutes in now?
But why?
WWE stuff? I'm already sick of it.
But why are we...
You're making me relive Monday and Tuesday nights all over again.
What?
On Wednesdays.
Because we're not talking about anything. Why are we having 2 out of 3 matches all the time?
Just to prove that you can win 2 out of 3 matches.
Are you sick of... Becky and Seth as well.
Oh my God! Did you see how awkward that interview was?
I didn't know if they were going to start singing "Tricky"
I thought they were having a stroke.
Wow! So it sets up for a mixed match,
and they couldn't bring in an ambulance because they were already had
gone. Two big
two
men.
Two of them gone.
You can only have two ambulances.
And
in
they
each
almost
event.
Dropped Braun.
They did. It'd be like me trying to pick up you.
What? Yeah, don't try it. Get a crane.
Like the cranes that they use when he's tipping everything over?
Yeah.
What did you think of the Canalises coming out? And
basically, my bitch versus your bitch.
And then she just yells she's pregnant. I'm pregnant! And she's legit, the dirt sheets are saying, she's legit pregnant, and now WWE is pissed at her because they just signed a 5-year deal. So now she's on the shelf for a little bit. Her and Ronda can go drink tea with...
Ronda pregnant, too?
Not yet, but...
She's trying.
She's trying.
I don't even care if Ronda ever comes back.
I really don't either.
I wish her and Lesnar would get some cocktail Coors Lights. Somewhere else.
Just Coors, the banquet beers.
No, because he was like, when Brock Lesnar first won his UFC championship, he was like, I'm going to drink Coors Lights because Bud Light won't pay me anything. Okay, well, there's a good way to not get the biggest sponsor UFC has to not sponsor their heavyweight champion. Idiot.
He is an idiot. He just made the list.
You know what happens, Brock? Where are we at now?
We're on Kevin Owens' show. You wanted to talk about it.
Oh, yeah. Well, I thought we already talked about it.
No.
So Kevin comes out, and he has McMahon and Drew McIntyre.
What was
as
that?
As a guest. Oh, I couldn't remember his name. Drew McIntyre as his guest, and McMahon handed Kevin Owens some cards, and Kevin wasn't having it. So Kevin is a heel, but he is a heel to everybody. Good guys, bad guys, all the in-betweens. All of a sudden, Zig's music hits.
He's your new Stone Cold. Do you realize that, right?
Yeah, but he's not my new Stone Cold. He's
to a point of on paper where he hates this person, he hates this person. He might, you know, play patty cake one night with him, but the next night he's going to kick him in the crotch.
Yeah, how about in the guts and heading out the Canadian Stunner?
All right, Canadian Stunner. I don't know. I don't know. Your boys. Steaks and Weights.
Steaks and Weights, baby! Steaks and Weights, Marky! Yeah!
I think at Extreme Rules they win the title.
I hope to God so.
I really do, because you think they're over.
I think they're over. I think that when you have a match in Washington State against Daniel Bryan, who is from Washington State, going to get a draw there. You're not going to get applause. Daniel Bryan could have pooped in a hat and put it on a child, and they still would have cheered it.
Right?
Miggy was excited about that,
Miggy
too.
Miggy likes poop as well. I still can't get behind him. I can't.
You will.
Almas just beats down Cruz. No rhyme or reason for this match. But it was set to take place months ago, they said. I don't remember that was supposed to take place.
Yeah. Apollo's been trying to get Almas for months now.
And what'd it do?
Nothing. Maybe it's for Finn's title or something. I don't know.
Alexis and Nikki. Nikki wins against Bayley. And everybody now wants her in the Extreme Rules match. It happens next week.
Oh, yeah. Triple threat.
Nikki wins. Nikki is going to win the
Nikki
title.
Nikki Cross wins the title.
Yeah.
And Alexa turns on her.
Yeah. And there's your feud for the next 2 months.
And Bayley gets
bailed again. Done.
And they only gave Bayley the title because they wanted to throw it in Sasha's face.
And Sasha is not brought up. I mean, clearly they're not going to bring her up on WWE, but I mean, if you follow Sasha on social media, she's doing her own thing. She's anything Cody Rhodes puts out there. Love you, Cody. You're retweeting her. Anything. But there's no more Sasha except for one commercial. Cricket. You see that they're still playing the Sasha one?
Well, yeah.
I figured WWE would make Cricket make a new ad was the word I was looking for. I just couldn't think of it because it was so long. It's a long word.
It's a big word.
So many syllables. What are they doing with Sonya and Mandy? Is this going to be a love triangle?
I hope so.
Not for you.
Oh, never mind. What are you talking about? It already is.
It is, yeah. Those late nights when T's working, it's a love triangle, all right. I don't know what they're doing with Ember, is what makes me mad.
Ember is unhappy with WWE, too. You're going to find out that she is going to... If this whole Sasha thing goes the way Sasha is planning on it, you're going to see a couple other WWE superstars do the exact same thing.
How long can Sasha sit out, though, with her contract? I mean, I don't know if it's a year or two.
She could sit out forever.
And then her contract date comes to an end. They are going to extend it because they're not there. I mean, how does this play out? I mean, I'd like to know
I'm sure legality-wise is going to be way over our head. But sooner or later, they're just going to just stop. They're going to have to. Either way, they're like, I don't know if she's not showing up, if she's still collecting a check. But if she's not there, why should she be collecting a check?
Right.
So why are you paying somebody to not be there?
I don't know. I don't.
That doesn't make sense to me. If somebody doesn't want to be there, you should be like, guess what? You're gone.
Yeah, if you were so...
Because there's always another person to take their place. And I'm not saying that there's another Sasha Banks, but there is somebody out there that's better than Sasha Banks.
Oh, yeah. I'm not... You have a lot of talent in NXT. Baszler can come up. The other four horsewomen can come up. I mean, that spot can be filled. That's what we're talking about. Not the legit boss, but the spot can be filled with somebody. Like, I think Baszler should be up. Baszler. Yeah. I think she should be up. Irie can be up. You know, there's so many that can be up, but there's so many more that nothing against.
They're not ready yet.
Alicia Fox has been dead weight.
Yeah.
You're going to punch me. I don't think Nat's got a lot going on anymore.
Not anymore. And that's sad because she is so... But she is so enthroned.
This is a new word.
Enshrined in history.
WWE's WWF hearts. Yes. You think of that, right?
All the time. So I don't know if they ever get rid of her, but there isn't much.
I don't think she's one saying, hey, I want to go.
No. No. And she's one that says, hey, I want another push. I want to get back into it. But there's nothing for girls like her.
Women, Paul. Women, it's 2019,
like,
Paul.
A female like her in her stage of her career besides the women's championship. The women's tag team championship, maybe, but there's not another, if she could find another heart woman, but there isn't. You know what I'm saying?
A heart woman?
Yeah.
Is that like a heart doctor?
No, like a heart, a family member.
Oh, right. And I don't think there is. No. I really don't. This is why I know people are saying, oh, too many titles. The women still don't have. Let's separate them. The men may be too many titles. I'm all right with that. But whatever. The women have two titles.
I would love to see the women take
the TV title.
The 24/7 TV European Championship.
Which hasn't happened yet. Any superstar. Remember when this first came out? Any superstar far and wide.
Yeah.
Whatever. A legend can come back. Well, we haven't had a legend come back and get it yet. So it's going to happen. I really thought Mella once was going to... Maybe she was waiting until the Stand By Your Man tournament was over.
Right.
And now that she's out, maybe she could have screwed over R-Truth. She had so many opportunities.
Or have R-Truth there. He gets rolled over by Drake Maverick and she takes it from Drake Maverick.
Right, yeah, she doesn't need to take it right from R-Truth. But why hasn't a woman already had it?
Right.
Why didn't a legend come back yet? This title's now been 2 months, right? Maybe three.
Three.
I don't know. Three people have held the damn thing.
Right. And R-Truth has held it nine times.
Yeah. How many by the end of the year?
At least breaking Ric Flair's record.
Yeah. But that could be... That could be... By the end of the month.
You got a little Seth Rollins and Becky Lynch going on there right now, buddy.
I do. And speaking of that, let's go English professor, garbage tip, and all that. Wrap it up.
Yeah, let's wrap it up.
All right.
I sat at the bar of my favorite Chinese restaurant gulping a Yingling while I waited for my takeout order. I watched the highlights and post-game interviews of the Pirates' 2-1 loss to the Brewers while other patrons compared Pittsburgh's storied baseball history to the Pirates' uninspiring recent history. McCutcheon never wanted to leave, one man said with exasperation as he smacked his beer bottle on the counter. And neither did Walker, he continued. He's from here. Neil Walker's Gibsonia roots eased the tension of the Pirates' loss as we started discussing people from the area who made it. Sharon Stone is from Meadville. My favorite Batman, Michael Keaton, is from Coriopolis. When I'd visit my old neighborhood in the early 90s, friends were eager to show me the Brooklyn locations of certain scenes from A Bronx Tale. The restaurant that Ray Liotta and Joe Pesci set on fire in Goodfellas was a block away from my mother's bakery. We all like to see people we knew way back when make it. It gives us a connection to the success they're enjoying. This is especially true in pro wrestling. I'd bet Stone and Keaton had their share of support and encouragement from family and friends. But for wrestlers performing in an industry long regarded as the illegitimate child of the entertainment world, the support and encouragement from family is perhaps different for some of them. Kurt Angle has said that his family often asked him why he wanted to get involved in that fake stuff. For some wrestlers, perhaps they receive greater support and encouragement from us, the fans. We go to their matches. We want to meet them at intermission. We want pictures and T-shirts. We joke with them. We're brutally honest about what we think of them. And because fan involvement is crucial to a successful wrestling program, we fans claim a certain amount of credit when a wrestler gets over or moves to a larger promotion. It's cool to see AJ Styles as one of the faces of WWE after seeing him in IWC shortly after the company's inception. I'm looking forward to his heel run, and I think he and Gallows and Anderson will make an effective faction. It's also fun to see Elias, another local guy. But I was especially pumped last Wednesday when I saw DJ Z, now known as Joaquin Wilde, make his way into the ring and shout into my living room, ba-ba-ba-ba! This was still a surprise to me, even though the Can Crushers were in attendance for DJ Z's last match in IWC, where Marks shouted, NXT, NXT, NXT. To which DJ Z replied, hey, I ain't saying nothing. Ain't is not a word, Mr. Wilde. Plus, he used a double negative. Wilde was fittingly seated in the breakout tournament, and his opponent was a man oozing with machismo. No, not that guy. It was Angel Garza, a talented third-generation wrestler. I was nervous for Wilde for a brief moment, but his confidence quickly put me at ease and allowed me to enjoy what was a very good match. The fans in attendance agreed as they chanted, Fight Forever! Aside from his dazzling athleticism that his fans always knew he had, Wilde performed moves and used body language reminiscent of an anxious newbie with something to prove. His miscues helped tell the story that Garza was more experienced and perhaps knew an extra trick or two due to his wrestling lineage. Wilde took his eyes off of Garza and ate a sucker punch. He also attempted a head scissor takedown, which Garza turned into a faceplant. After Garza's failed pin attempt following a Spanish fly, Wilde quickly countered with a crucifix pin, leading many fans to believe he was going to steal the win. Once Garza kicked out of the crucifix, Wilde took a deep breath. Whether Wilde needed to take a deep breath or whether that was part of his performance is unclear. And as our good buddy Al Snow says, it's about making them guess what's real. Wilde's brief pause helped us understand that the crucifix pin was an opening that he willed himself to seize, but that he didn't have much left after that. Nigel McGuinness referenced his time in the ring against Wilde and used the word precision to describe him. Wilde nailed a combination of moves, including an inverted atomic knee drop, a drop onto his back where he drove his heels into Garza's chin, and a roll-up pin, taking his time with each portion of the sequence and focusing on precision rather than fluidity. Later, when Wilde went for an aerial attack on Garza outside the ring, Garza ran to the other side of the ring for safety. Wilde watched Garza and took a moment to make sure Garza wasn't going anywhere before jumping through the ropes on top of him. These subtle pauses are the signs of a pro who understands the art of storytelling and adds layers and realism to a wrestler's performance. In the end, it was Garza catching Wilde in a butterfly suplex position and dropping him on his spine in an innovative combination of a powerbomb spine buster for the win. The rest of the NXT card was very good as usual. The Street Profits can talk and work, but the Can Crushers know who started the red tights and solo cup look. Shout out to our boys in Toronto. Io Shirai and Shayna Baszler put on a steel cage match that hopefully Kofi Kingston and Dolph Ziggler watched. The ladies combined MMA strikes, submission wrestling, and jiu-jitsu and showed how you can effectively use the cage in a G-rated era of professional wrestling. And Shirai's post-match meltdown, in which she attacked Candice LeRae, left me stunned and betrayed. A few years ago, Joaquin Wilde, then known as DJ Z, was IWC World Heavyweight Champion. After the event, I saw him as Mark and I were leaving. I said, On a card filled with great matches, you stole the show. He said, thank you. And that's what a main event should be, he continued. It should be the best match of the night. I'd like to tell Wilde today that on an NXT card filled with great matches, Joaquin Wilde versus Angel Garza, the opening match, was pretty darn good. In today's English Tip of the Week, let's take a look at subject and predicate agreement. The subject is simply the topic of the sentence. It's a noun. The predicate is just a fancy way of saying the verb. The predicate says what the subject is doing. In a simple example, the sentence, I wrestle, has the subject I and the predicate wrestle. The two need to agree. For instance, I wouldn't say, I wrestles. I could say, she wrestles. In this instance, she is the subject and wrestles is the predicate. Let's have a look at some wrestlers who got it wrong and see if we can correct them. In his inspiring Hard Times promo, Dusty Rhodes says, "Hard times is when a man work a job 30 years. 30 years. They give him a watch, kick him in his butt, and tell him a computer took your job, daddy. That's hard times." We all agree with the sentiment, but did Big Dusty's proper noun and verb agreement? Not quite. The American Dream said, "A man work a job." You would say, "I work," or "you work," but for the third person, you would say, "A man works a job," not "a man work a job." When Mr. Fuji betrayed Tiger Chung Lee and left him to fend for himself against the Wild Samoans, fans were stunned. Mr. Fuji let it be known that he was the leader of that team and that Tiger Chung Lee had failed to follow orders.
"When I tell Tiger Chung Lee what to do, he do. But he don't listen. So I make him suffer like dirty inferior dog."
While we have more of an understanding into Mr. Fuji's devious plot, we have less of an understanding of his lack of noun-verb agreement. Mr. Fuji said he do, and he don't listen. If we're using the third person he, then Mr. Fuji should have said he does, and he doesn't listen. Finally, Rowdy Roddy Piper enjoyed doing color commentary because he loved the sport of fighting.
"I loves to fight," Piper said, "and I loves to see a good fight."
One thing Hot Rod didn't love was noun-verb agreement. The subject, or the noun in this sentence, is I. The predicate, or verb, is love. Hot Rod is speaking of the first person, I. So the sentence should be, "I love to fight, and I love to see a good fight." Not, "I loves to fight, and I loves to see a good fight." And with that, class,
you're dismissed.
This is William Alexander Moore, and you are listening to Can Crushers Podcast.
But now it's time for my favorite part of the show. Is that how you do a compound sentence? I guess I started it with but.
Yeah, I don't think you start with but.
You can't start with but. You have to have something.
But I think he was talking about predications and predicals. I don't know what the hell he was talking about. Hey, it's summer. There should be no sessions.
Yeah, I fall asleep every time he starts to talk. It's like English class back in high school.
You slept during that.
But you know what I don't sleep during, Mark?
Garbage tip!
Our stick, and then the garbage tip of the week. Let's go through the stick, Mark.
Go!
Pro Printing and Office, LLC, 814-383-4-3006. Holy shnikes. Call Dave All for all your printing needs.
That number has not changed in a year.
I get it wrong. I get so excited about this that I can't even read.
Yeah, collar and elbow, hats, hoodies, sweats, tees, all your fan apparel, and there's a special code.
It's no more secret, Mark. It's not a secret anymore. We're telling everybody.
Everybody!
OVW, when you check out, it's 10% off.
For the millions!
And millions of Can Crusher fans!
Speaking of that, we saw a couple Can Crushers fans this week on... Today, actually.
Today. Yeah. The West End Groceries. Yeah. We were getting our lunches.
Shout out to Michael Gerg and Otto Schneiderman.
Thanks, homies.
Yeah.
We appreciate you saying that you like our show, and we can't believe that you're still listening to us.
Right?
You know, Ridgeway is such a boring town for you kids, I'm sorry. So you're welcome, and thank you for listening to us.
Send us an email at cancrusher69@gmail.com, and we'll answer it on air.
We got Facebook and Instagram, both at cancrusher69. You can message us on there, too. Not saying that we're going to get back to you, but you could do it.
Mark will.
Our website, https://cancrusher69.wixsite.com/cancrusher.
So many places to listen to us. And we'll start with Wrestle Post the app first.
Is this on your phone?
It's on your phone.
Is it on your phone?
It's on my phone.
Is it on my phone?
It's not on your phone.
How did you know?
I know.
Damn it. I'm going to download it.
You can find
it. Do you know where I can
wrestling.
Find it at?
Yeah. iTunes or Google Store?
Google Store. Yeah. Google Play Store.
Yeah.
And that's WrestlePost app.
WrestlePost app.
Okay.
You can also hear us on Alexa, Boxcast, Overcast.
WrestlePost app.
TuneIn Radio, Google Podcasts, iTunes.
WrestlePost app.
Bullhorn, Stitcher.
WrestlePost app.
iHeartRadio.
WrestlePost app.
And Spotify.
WrestlePost app as well!
Right? It's on your phone.
Lots of wrestling July 13th.
There's a ton of wrestling.
The Shamrock Cup in New Arena. Mew Arena.
It's MCW.
Oh, it looks like an E.
MCW Arena in Joppa, Maryland. The Rated X, Pat Lupino, and myself will be going to this. Nick Aldis will be defending his NWA championship. And Scarlett
Bedouin
is going to be there. Also that day,
Roll July 13th, triple level threat midnight. Triple
what?
Threat level triple midnight. It's dark out. I can't see. But it's IWC and Elizabeth PA. Sean Spears will be there.
He will be there.
And who's our correspondent on that night?
Correspondent is IRS Soup, whatever you want to call him. He will be bringing us all the coverage from that.
It's also threat level midnight.
Right.
There was no triple in it. I get super excited when I do this.
And speaking of IWC, you can subscribe to their monthly network. It's $9.99 a month, and you'll get all the old IWCs. You'll get the pay-per-views as they happen. So it's $9.99 a month. Just get it. Yeah, we're going to get to that one. Wait. We're going to get to that one.
Just trying to figure it out, Mark.
This one's next. I didn't put
them
in
order. No, it's not next.
Yes, it is.
No, this one's next.
Okay.
Because it's July 19th. The 19th comes before the 20th.
Yes, it does.
You're welcome. Iron City Homecoming, Monroeville, PA, July 19th, Billy Gunn, Christy Hamm, Pillman Jr.
Hemi, you're Ron Burgundy today. You are horrible.
You write it on the prop so grossly. Funaki's going to be there, Corey Graves. I'm gonna go to this just to punch Corey Graves in the mouth.
His brother, Sam Adonis, and Jerry the King Lawler.
Great. I'm done talking about this because Corey Graves is going to be there. I'm already pissed about it.
Sorry. Jeez Louise.
Don't call me Louise.
July 20th in Jerome, Pennsylvania. Rolling Thunder. It's pretty much Imagine Pro Wrestling.
Yeah, it is Imagine. Well, pretty much Imagine. You know who's going to be there?
Paul Ellering.
Oh, what a rush!
You know who would be really proud of you right there for doing that?
Chris Severs.
Yep.
Yes, he would.
Carrying his title around.
Animal is going to be there from the LOD. War Kings, Manny Fernandez.
And Jaden Roller, the Heartthrob.
Jaden Roller, the Heartthrob.
From OVW. And then also, our favorite. Now.
Mark's favorite.
You're not about this one?
I like this one.
You like it. It's my favorite. It is Stomp Out Cancer 3.
Trace.
Yes. It's going to be at the Stronghold Arena.
L3O.
In Lamont Furnace. Guys, if you don't know where the hell that's where Rise holds all their events.
That was Spanish for the three.
It was, the three.
Okay. There's a Bullet Club member going to be there.
And? We got confirmation. We are good to go.
We're giving away two tickets.
GA tickets.
Two GA tickets. General admission.
Which it doesn't matter.
You people
that
don't like to abbreviate things.
Right. And you hate when I abbreviate anything.
Because I would have said two God tickets.
Right. Today. What the hell is a God ticket?
What's a God ticket? And then I was like, oh, there's periods there. But they're not very...
They're not there. I just figured...
There's periods on the other side that bled through and it was amazingly well placed.
See? Notes. This is why my wife asks. She's like, you're writing notes again? I'm like, Paul doesn't understand what we're doing yet. It's been 13 months.
I really come here, I crack a beer, and I'm like, all right, let's talk about things, and I'm just going to make fun of stuff and sing songs.
But you're the ones, I never get a note. So when I write notes, you don't know how to read.
I
you
don't
turn
know
into
how to
Eugene
read.
Or Paul Nasty or somebody.
Or, what was...
There's so many other people I could
what
say.
What was Anders' name before he was Fungus or Fegus?
First of all, it was Gallows.
Gallows.
And it was Festus.
Festus, that's what it was. Who was a mute, dumb guy until the bell rung, and then he was all wrestling.
Matt Morgan kind of did it, too. And then, once he did start to talk, he had a stutter and impact. That's you, as well.
I'm a wee bit of a stutter.
Yeah. The music's playing. The music's playing.
Real slow because I don't know if you know this, but I have a bit of an accent.
Know what you're making me think of right now?
Nikki Cross
no.
doing Moment of Bliss, and we didn't even put that on the show earlier.
No, you're making me think, my name is Simon. I like to do drawings. You don't know, that's it's way before your time.
So, our garbage tip of the week.
You're probably going to piss William Alexander Moore off.
Well, I mean, this is a better accent than William Alexander Moore.
His isn't an accent. He's legit from England.
Right. I believe that when he rides his polo horse up and says, hey, I'm bloody from England. Good job.
I can't wait till I go down to OVW and send you a video.
He better be riding a horse with his polo stick. We're really off.
Chad Miller, we need a horse during the draft. So I can record this for
and
Paul.
Send it to Paul. So can we go on with this garbage tip of the week?
I already know what it is.
Well, you're going to have to tell everybody because you said it and then I don't remember it. Write it down.
Of course. Guys, it's getting hot, sticky, stinky.
Oh, yeah. Real stinky.
And there's maggots. If you're the people that throw legit raw food and this random rubbish into your can
without a bag,
you're gonna have stinky cans.
You're the worst kind of garbage people.
You are the worst kind of. I
no, the dog poop people are still dog poop unbagged are still the worst kind of dog or garbage people.
Yeah,
you're the second worst kind of garbage.
Wash your cans out. This is not a hard one.
No, it's just
everybody's got a hose.
Yeah, just hose it out a little bit. Throw a little bit of bleach in there.
I don't even care if the bleach is in there or not.
Well, I mean, it helps. Really clean it.
It
that'll
does
really
help.
Get it nice and clean.
It just gets rid of the stuff that just sticks and it is baked on.
You know what we're going to do? We're not going to polish this baby up. But we are going to turn that sumbitch sideways and stick it straight up your catty ass. No, we can't do that either.
We're not allowed.
That's not.
We'd nice. Like to.
Well, I don't know if we'd like to.
I would.
But I don't like violence.
I started lots of violence this week. I'm good to go. Remember, Paul, I'm trash.
Remember, Mark, just because you closed down the pool early, it doesn't mean that you're trash. It means you can do great things. It's called a garbage can, not a garbage cannot.
There's wrestling this weekend. Find it. You just blew
you know
my
where
mind.
You know where you can find it at?
YouTube.
Nope. WrestlePost app.
Oh.
Nailed it.
MLW actually has a show. It's free on BN Sports. Watch it.